Change. Change is inevitable. Change is the reason we all here. Change is something which is dynamic, and the only thing in the world which is permanent is change. Nothing else can, nothing static about it. John F. Kennedy has very clearly said, change is the law of life, and those who look only to the past and present are certain to miss out on the future. The future is always exciting, the future is random, the future is extraordinary, and as technology adds on to it, the future gets even more exciting. So we come to change. Change occurs because of what? Needs, then? Okay, I'll take you through. I have the three C's on change. The first reason for change is because you choose it, right? You make a choice. You're not happy, whatever. You decide, okay, I choose this career instead of that. So first you make your choice. So the first C, change occurs because you choose change. The next one, can you just give me another one? So the first one is, you choose it. The next one, suppose you don't choose, then what happens? One more C, chance. You get a chance, and that chance makes you change, right? You get an opportunity, you get an opening, and then you say, okay, now I'll choose this. If you're going in for a job, you're already looking at one job. Now there's a second job available. There's an opening available. What will you do? Will you take it? So there, again, change will occur because of chance. Now if you don't take the first, you don't choose, and you don't change because of chance, there could be the last scene. Exactly. Head in boiling water completely. Don't know what to do. Ab bhag nahi padega. There's no question asked. You're out of it. Crisis will force you to change. Please understand. Change is inevitable. So you decide what you want to do. You want to choose it. You want to take your chances, or you want to wait for the crisis till the end of it, and then you will finally have nowhere to go. You know, back to the wall sort of syndrome. So with this, giving you the thing is, innovation is constant because innovation is a part of change. Okay, how many of y'all have seen a movie 5 times? Get a life, man. Get a life. There's nothing new about the movie. Look at something better. You see it once, you see it twice. After that, I think you're done with it. Look at something better. So what happens actually, you have to look at innovation, you have to look at what does innovation do? It adds value to a company, it has commercial advantages. We already had that discussed in the by the two previous speakers. Customers are willing to pay you more, right? iPhone 6, you have to put 2 laptops of Acer, possibly to get one iPhone 6. Right? And what is that? What's so great about iPhone 6? Nothing. Half an inch of screen extra. And something which already Android possibly had. And that's what you call iPhone 6, and they call it innovation. Anyway, that's the market will so decide. But still it's innovation. And if you don't innovate, very, very, very important, you'll hit the C. You'll come to crisis. You'll come to crisis mode. You'll not, and you'll run the risk of losing, as Mr. Harsh said, locking in the customer. You risk losing out on your customer. So finally what happens? You lose your customer, then what happens? Sales decline, then what happens? Not Steve Jobs, but your job declines. Okay? That's it. And then the key, the differentiation, I'll come to this, is very, very important. This last point, it distinguishes market leaders and their rivals. How good you are at innovating, how good you are. I still remember once upon a time we had the SEBI chairman who came and addressed Bangalore Stock Exchange. And at one point of time, he said, see, you guys have to innovate. And he used the example of the king cobra, the mythical snake. How long does the snake normally live? They say the king cobra lives 30 years, 50 years, maybe 100 years. That's the myth about it. But there's something more about this, the snake, which is very unique, which makes it live a little longer. being a reptilian, still it lives quite long, and the reason is it sheds its skin once in 6 months. It reinvigorates itself, reinvents itself. So there is some amount of change which takes place, which makes it live. So now we come to the industry part of it. You can decide what you want to do. Remember, you have something which is objective, there are desires, there's technology, and then the third matrix, the third one in that is sustainability. If all these three get married together, the subset of that, you can definitely innovate, and it's viable. So if you don't do anything, you're here. No risk. Two, breakthrough innovation strategy, high risk and high R&D expenditure. A lot of companies today, if you can just go and Google it, most of the top end companies which are actually innovating are spending a huge amount of their revenues, in double digit figures of their revenues, only on innovation and breakthrough strategy. And that's the cutting edge. That's what separates you from the boys. So what do? How do you actually start? You start mobilizing for it, then you go into the effectiveness of it, see it, and then you sustain innovation. But this curve looks very nice. There's something wrong with it. Tell me what? Change. Sustain. Correct. You are walking on an escalator which is coming down. You feel you've reached it, and lo behold, you're still back. The moment you stop walking, it drags you back. That's it. What happened? First of all, let's take us to a mobile. Simple. First, we had one with a big antenna protruding out. That was the first mobile of mine. 1998. Big one. The bigger the antenna, the better it looked, you know. So, I used to pay 16, 8 and 4 rupees for a minute. Then the antennas got smaller, antennas disappeared. Then the screen, the mobiles which are palm size and, you know, foot size and all that came down to palm size. Then you started getting color display. And then you got polyphonic ringtones. And then you thought, ah, this is the end of it. And then they said, change it again and again. And now your tablet has become a tablet and your phone has become a smartphone, right? Your TV has become a smart TV. Do you think it's the end of it? Answer is no. You just reach somewhere and you're back. The escalator will pull you down again. So you need to run on the escalator to even be where you are. To be a leader, you have to run. And if you have to run, you have to invest. And if you have to invest, you have to innovate. And change is constant. Please be paranoid of it. The only mantra I can tell you is either you innovate or perish. That's it. So now coming with that, I'll give you case studies from my own life example. I've changed 5 organizations. Just thinking about it. So we come to the first one of Bangalore Stock Exchange. I take you to the time of some prehistoric, but of course we used to do it. It was before 1992, not too far away. You know, behind that's actually the rotunda, the big building of Bombay Stock Exchange. We had a smaller one, and we had a floor where everybody used to come. We called that the pit. And used to scream, shout, and, you know, buy and sell our stocks. That's what we used to do. It was called the outcry. And that's the way we used to transact business. We used to transact business from 12 to 2. So this outcry system had inefficiencies, the spreads were higher, there were certain things called jobbers, and the investors were not getting good prices. So then what happened? Bombay Stock Exchange was the only stock exchange which was there, and it had to, you know, it was like a big monopoly. I think everybody used to call it a club. From there then what happened? You come back, 1992, you have the formation of Sabka Bada Bhai, SEBI. So, Securities Exchange Board of India. Then after that you have 1994 electronic trading. For the first time, now your order matching order. You are having nobody in between. The best buyer, the best seller come on the price and